Good morning, students. This is Arindam Bagh here. Welcome to my YouTube channel again. So, as per our plan, today we are going to deal with the main story, which is actually not main story. Rather, I must say the particular story which is included in our syllabus. So, we'll be looking for that one. So, previously we have done the story of Cadmus and Actaeon. Now, this time we are going to deal with the story of birth of Bacchus, how Bacchus was born. So, who is Juno? Juno is actually the wife of Jupiter. Now, who is Jupiter? Let me give you some idea who is Jupiter. I told you earlier that Jupiter is the king of God, or he is the head of the gods. So, here we have some information. You can see in my screen that Jupiter, it is he is known as Jove, and he has been usually thought to have originated as a sky god, and implement is the thunderbolt, and his primary sacred animal is the eagle. These are his symbols, you can see that. Now here we have a picture over here on my right hand side. You can see a picture of Jupiter. So let me show you some other pictures of Jupiter. Here we have, you can see this one. He has been described in such a fashion. Okay, so he is the king of God, and he is enormously powerful. So you can do that. If you want to look for it, you can go through the Google image, and there you will find it. Now let us try to understand the story which I am about to deal with. What is the story we have here? Now, Juno wants to punish Semele. Now, who is Semele? Semele is just a woman who belongs to the world. He is just a human. Now, why Juno wants to punish Semele? Juno is the wife of Jupiter, and Jupiter had a relationship with Semele, and out of the relationship Semele becomes pregnant. Now you must be wondering that why the king god is involved with other omens while he has a wife. So in the Roman mythology and in the Greek mythology also, we have seen that being the god, being the king of the god, Jupiter made multiple relationships. There are so many stories where Jupiter is involved with beautiful omens. In this part also, in book 3 also, yeah, I mentioned about Europa. She was also abducted by Jupiter. So so what will you say? He is a characterless person. In our modern definition, he is, but according to that time, he is a symbol of power, and yes, obviously power attracts women. Women's also, they knew very well that Jupiter is married, Jupiter is a god, they were not supposed to involve with him, and Juno will be furious. Still, they took this risk, and there are many stories where you will find that due to Jupiter, there are many half gods. That means he somehow involves himself with women and the children out of that relationship. They were half god. They were neither completely human, they are not completely god. They are half god. So Juno sets out to punish Semele. Now there was you can see that Juno is not happy with this relationship that her husband is in affair. No wife will accept it. So does Juno also, and Juno is very jealous also. She doesn't punish Jupiter, or she is unable to punish Jupiter. So she takes kind of revenge. Out of vengeance, she punishes those women who were involved with Jupiter. This is her tendency. This is what she do. Now the debate is undecided. To some, the punishment is more violent than just. Some people consider that Juno is sometimes very much, you know, cruel in her punishment. Whether that particular woman, whoever she is, whether she deserves it or not, it doesn't matter. It is Juno. She can do anything. So other approves it and call it fitting because of a strict vow of virginity, and both can make a case. Jupiter's wife was saying nothing, neither of praise or blame. She was glad of the disaster that had come down to the house of Agnor, and transferred her hatred from Europa to those who were allied to the Tyrian girl by birth. Yep, you can understand why she was happy with this, because the things happened earlier, that the story of, you know, Cadmus, then the story of Actaeon. Juno is happy with this because it is happening in the house of Agnor. And the daughter of Agnor, Europa, had a relationship with Jupiter. So that's why she is happy with this, that this disaster is happening in this particular family. Then there was a fresh wrong added to the first. She was grieved by the fact that Semele was pregnant with the seed of mighty Jove. Swallowing words of reproach, she said, "What in truth have I gained from frequent reproaches? I must attack her if I am rightly to be called most powerful Juno." Yep. She did it again. So she's a kind of jealous person, and I told you she had her own justification and reason, and every time she take a drastic step against those people who were involved with Jupiter. So she says, "If I am queen and sister and wife of Jove," why sister? Yep, she is the sister of Jupiter also. Back in those days, it was common. Even in the case of pharaohs, you will find that they used to marry sister and brother. They used to marry each other. It was the custom. Later on, it was removed. But back in those days, it was perfectly okay. So she decided to attack her, and then "I must destroy," and she is thinking to kill or destroy Semele, because she considered it to be a sin. Knowing Jupiter is married, she still, Semele still made relationship with Jupiter. This is something which she considered as crime or immoral. But on the other hand, you need to know or understand that why she is not saying anything to Jupiter. She will not say anything to Jupiter. She is unhappy with Jupiter, but she will try to punish those women who are involved with Jupiter, because she thinks that the women are, in this case, they are making mistake. But one more thing also here, who can deny the king of God? Being an woman, it's not easy to resist king of gods, because he is very powerful. So that's why now in this case also she thinks, "I must destroy. Yet I think she is content with her secret, and the injury to my marriage will be brief. But she has conceived, and that damages me." So in the relationship, Semele already conceived. She is pregnant right now. That makes the situation more dangerous. Making relationship and having an affair, still she can, you know, go up with. But having a baby out of that relationship will challenge his reputation, her reputation, and challenge her position also. So that's why she says, makes her crime visible in her swollen belly. Swollen belly means the belly of, you know, Semele. She is pregnant. And once what I have barely achieved to be confirmed as the mother of Jupiter's child. So great is her faith in her beauty. I will render that faith hollow. I am not Saturnina. If she does not plunge into the Stygian waters, overwhelmed by Jove himself. So here we can see that Juno wants to be a mother also from the mighty Jupiter, but unfortunately she is unable to do so. And that's why she says, "I have barely achieved to be confirmed as the mother of Jupiter's child." So what happens? She visited Semele, And at this she rose from her seat and cloaked in a dark cloud. She came to Simile's threshold. But before she removed the cloud, she disguised herself as an old woman. So she chose to remain in disguise, aging her hair, plowing her skin and wrinkles, and walking with bowed legs and tottering steps, as if she is really old person, so that Simile might believe her. She made her voice sound old and was herself Bero, Simile's Epididium nurse. So when they came to Jupiter's name in the midst of their lengthy gossiping, she sighed and said, "I hope for your sake that it really is Jupiter." So it's kind of, Juno is trying to taunt Simile. But she is making a statement which shows a suspicion that whether you are you sure that this is the child you are bearing with, it is actually of Jupiter. So she made some comment like this: "I am suspicious. It's not good enough for him to merely to be Job. Many at that time, many people may see." She also says that many people says that they are actually bearing the son of they are bearing the child of Jupiter, which is actually not true. So many men have entered the bedrooms of chaste women in the name of the gods. Yes, that's the point. Some people took advantage of this situation. So it is not good enough for him merely to be Job. So doesn't mean that the man, whoever enters in the bedroom of a chaste woman, he will be Jupiter. Maybe he is making it. He is giving false statement also. He must give a proof of his love if it is truly is him. So he is she is asking Simile that did you find out whether did you try to find the evidence that the person with whom you are having this affair, he is actually Jupiter. Beg him to assume all his powers before he embraces you. And she says that if he is Jupiter, then he is very powerful, then ask him to appear before Simile with all his powers, and ask him to embrace you with all his power. Now I must tell you, Jupiter is a very powerful god, and when he try to, or when he meets Simile, he normally reduces his power and make love or come close to Simile with the full power. If Jupiter appears, then any person, any human standing in front of him will be consumed, will be destroyed. So Juno actually taunts Simile to do that. With such words, Juno called the unsuspecting daughter of Cadmus. Simile asked Jupiter for an unspecified gift. Now in this part you understand that what is the relationship between Cadmus and Simile. Cadmus is the father of Simile. So Simile asked Jupiter for an unspecified gift. "Choose," said the god. "He is god. He can give any gift to anyone." So Simile asked Jupiter, "I want a gift." God said, Jupiter said, "Well, go ahead. Nothing will be refused." And he promised that nothing will be refused. "And so that you may believe it more firmly, I swear it by the Stygian torrent, that is the divine conscience, the fear of God of all the gods." Now this is something you need to know. The idea of God, if anything they are determined to do, that will happen. And if they promise you something, that will happen. Nobody can change it, and even they will not change their words. This is the idea of the gods in this part, in this Roman myth or whatever myths you are going to read. So they are not going to change their course, they are not going to change their words. "Please, by her misfortune to successful and doomed to be undone by her lover's indulge," Simile said. "As Saturnina used to, Saturnina means it is the alternate name of Juno, used to your embrace when you enter into the pact of Venus. Give yourself to me." The god would have stopped her lips as she spoke, but her voice had already rushed into the air. So she asked Jupiter, "The way you embrace your wife, please embrace me with that full power." And the gods, listening to it, they were trying to stop her, but they were unable to do so, because it is already in the air. She spoke it. He groans, he cannot unwish it, or he answer it, because he already promised that whatever you will ask me, I will give it to you. So most sorrowfully he climbs the heights of heaven, and with it look gathered the trailing clouds, then added their vapors to lightning mixed with storm winds and thunder and fateful lightning bolts. Still he tries tries to reduce his power in whatever way he can and does not arm himself with the lightning with which he deposed 100-handed Typhoeus. It is too savage in his grasp. There is a lighter dart to which Cyclops' hands gave a less violent fire, a lesser anger. The gods call this his secondary weapon. Taking this, he enters Agner's house, but still Semele's mortal body could not endure the storm. She was consumed by the fire of her nuptial gift. So this is the situation we are having here. Jupiter is very powerful, and he carries his weapon and all the things, being a becoming a god, he is very powerful. So that's why Juno knows it very well. If he appears in his full power before Semele will be consumed, she will be destroyed, she will be killed. The infant bakers, finally Semele is dead, she is destroyed. The infant baker, still unfinished, is torn from the mother's womb. Now in this part also you can see that Semele was pregnant. So what will happen with the baby which is already within her? So Bacchus was plucked out, and it is to be believed that he is shewn into his father's thigh. So Jupiter shew his unborn baby, which is later the name will be Bacchus, the fetus. It has been shewed on his thigh to complete his full term. You know, it takes some time, 9 months at least, to complete the, you know, fetus into a complete human child. So he was sewed on the thigh of Zeus to complete its full term into his mother's sister. You know, his mother's sister reared him secretly in infancy, and then he was given to the nymphs of Mount Nysa, who hid him in their cave and fed him on milk. So Semele is basically the daughter of Cadmus, and Semele had a sister also. Her name is Ino. So after the birth, after the completion of the exact time, Bacchus was born, and he was handed over to his mother's sister. Her name is Ino, and she took care of Bacchus, and later on he was given to the nymphs of Mount Nysa, and there they hid him in their cave and fed him on milk. And this is the story of birth of Bacchus. I hope you liked it. Thank you for watching this video. I request you please like, share and subscribe my channel and help my channel to grow. Thank you again.